EOL, EOSL? What do these things even mean? Hey, thanks for joining us for In a Flash series, bite-sized insights for data center experts. My name is Chad Peters. I've been in the IT industry for nearly 25 years. Most of that time has been servicing and supporting equipment carrying a tool bag. Today, we're going to cover in our In a Flash series, what is EOL and what is EOSL? So think about those terms. What in the heck does EOL and EOSL even mean? Let's start with EOL. What that really means is the OEM, the original equipment manufacturer, says, hey, we're not going to market this thing anymore. We want you on something new. We're not going to sell it anymore. And really, we're going to pare down the amount of updates that we even write for that product because we want you into something new. Those updates I'm talking about are things like bug fixes. The original equipment manufacturer is going to reduce the amount of those updates drastically as that product gets older and certainly once it hits EOL. So that's EOL. Well, switching gears, let's kick it up a notch because EOL is that first trigger from the OEM to say, hey, we want you off of this product. Well, the second trigger, kind of the more in-your-face trigger, is EOSL, end of support life, or you might hear it called end of service life. Well, when that comes up, now the OEM is pressing down on the gas pedal a little bit harder. Now they're saying, look, you need to get off this product because guess what? Not only we're not going to sell it anymore, we're not going to service it either. And by the way, those updates that we kind of reduced down that you weren't getting as much of, now you get none. And so now that really gets you thinking and looking in the mirror, what do I do? Well, when do these things happen? These triggers I'm talking about. And again, think about them like artificial triggers. The OEM picks the dates, they pick the times. They're designed to induce a little fear into you. So when do they happen? Well, EOL usually happens somewhere in that 3 to 5 year mark. And then EOSL generally happens in that 5 to 7 year time frame. Now again, those times may vary, but that's typically what you see. So what does that mean to you and your data center? Well, first of all, start by looking in the mirror. I got an announcement. Is my stuff working? Is it performing the way it needs to perform? Are my end users happy? Is my business running? If it is, keep using it. If it's not, think about, can I upgrade it? Or do I ultimately have to replace it? Do I have to do what the OEM is suggesting? But there's a lot of steps before you go buy new, right? You can do a lot of upgrades, a lot of enhancements before you say, geez, I got to throw it out and I got to go get something new. So I mentioned that replacement is an option. Sure it is. If the hardware is not working for you, then yes, replacement is a way to go. But wait a minute. Let's say you look in the mirror and it is working for you and the OEM has put out that end of support life date. And you're going, wait a minute, it's working. I don't want to buy new. What can I do? Well, one option, look at a third-party maintenance provider. What that's going to do is extend the life of the product, and it's probably also going to save you some money along the way. We heard about EOL. We know about EOSL. How in the world do you find out when these things happen? Well, a couple ways. One, you might get an email from the OEM. They might reach out to you, and they might let you know it's coming. Maybe not, right? Maybe they don't reach out to you. Well, if they don't reach out to you, now you've got to put on your Sherlock Holmes hat and go out to their website and sift through all these web pages and try and find it for yourself. Because if you don't look for it and they didn't tell you, what's going to happen is you're going to get a gap in coverage because no one let you know it was going end of service life or end of support life. Well, a third option is you can go out to serviceexpress.com and use our easy database to look up and find these EOL and EOSL dates. In closing, as we think about this, is it time to refresh my equipment? If it's working for you and it's running for you and it's doing all the things your business needs, don't go buy new. What can you do? Look at a third-party provider. Extend the life of that product. Upgrade that product. Those are all great suggestions and tools that you can put in your tool bag. Lastly, you can refresh, right? If it just isn't working for you, then a refresh is certainly in the cards. But up until then, you can run that thing for a lot longer than what you thought you could. So thanks for joining us today in our In a Flash series on EOL and EOSL. If you liked what you heard, like, subscribe, comment. We want to hear from you.